The slower you swing, the further the ball goes. Slow in, fast out is the proper way to take a corner on its racing line. Driving a golf ball and driving a car both require attention to physics. As you turn the corner, centrifugal force wants to throw you off link. So instead of stamping your foot on the pedal, you had to squeeze the power on, accelerating smoothly like a pendulum. Or, to be more precise, like six pendulums joined together.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
In a proper golf swing, the arms do not swing from side to side, but just pendulum up in the backswing and down in the downswing. The wrist moves as a three-dimensional pendulum, driven by the synchronous operation of two hand pendulums swinging in two different planes. The wrist cock is parallel to the shoulder plane, and the wrist roll is orthogonal to it. The shoulders and hands are joined by the arms, creating a double pendulum. The length of the hand is much smaller than the width of the shoulders, so the wrist pendulum is correspondingly smaller. However, the hand holds the club, which is longer than the shoulder pendulum. The shoulder-wrist double pendulum is like a shepherd's slingshot, which transduces rotational momentum to linear momentum at the tangent to the rotation when the sling is released or when the club head hits the ball.
Nejan, that's the chair.
Flachmon.
Flachmon? What's the
تیر میزنم
چی را میزنی؟
آدم
ها آی خب نشان بده نه بزن دیگه آدم ها نزن خب
حالا دا این را ما دیرم آه خوب ها
The double pendulum project tile apparatus in the form of the ubiquitous Shepard's slingshot and the Australian Woomera is mankind's oldest known mechanical technology. Probably tens of thousands of years old, it uses the principle of the lever thousands of years before Archimedes thought of it, just as the hanging gardens of Nineveh, not Babylon, were irrigated by the screw lift thousands of years before Archimedes thought of that either. Indeed, maybe Archimedes never actually had an original idea, apart from streaking.
Eureka! Eureka!
The Woomera and slingshot require just as much skill and practice as the golf swing to stay on target. Because in all three cases, and in taking a corner in Formula One, it's all about timing. The timing of the acceleration of the double pendulum lever, so that both pendulums are traveling at top speed exactly at the moment of impact. But if you accelerate the upper pendulum too hard from the top, it will reach its nadir too soon and be already slowing down before the clubhead reaches the ball. And that will mean the lower pendulum will have to slow down too, so even if the overall elapsed swing time is fast, the club head speed at the moment of impact will be slower than it would have been if you had accelerated slowly and smoothly all the way down. Even worse, your subconscious mind will learn improvised adaptations to your over-the-top swing. But those adaptations to compensate for having got the basic double pendulum dynamics wrong in the first place will be a messy chain of muscle movements.
I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing.
This idiot comes in too fast, misses the apex, breaks in the corner, comes out slow. And then compounds his mistake by overaccelerating before he has straightened up, causing a spin. It's such a shame that a beautiful car like that should be in the hands of a heavy-footed klutz who doesn't know the first thing about physics. They should give it to me to drive instead.
And that's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not from Texas. That's right, you're not.